I'm in Sydney and I'm wanting to be head girl this year. This year I have a clear like agenda of things I want to see done more in the school. For instance, awareness. I feel like there's not enough done in the school, and if it's done, it's done quite quickly and we don't really take enough time to do it. For instance, Black History Month, we've been doing it, but it feels sometimes rushed and, you know, it doesn't feel like we could go to the full extent that we could. And then there's also, you know, you've got International Women's Day, and, you know, we don't really look at, like, celebrating women as we should. And it's really, like, important because, you know, the school is such an inclusive place, and being more aware of certain things like LGBTQ, like, all these things that we could be socially aware of, I don't think we're really taught enough in school. And obviously school is the place which sends you off to be like a member of society, and if we're not really socially aware of what's going on in society, then it kind of reflects back on here. Second of all, inclusion. Going off from the last point, I think that if we're more inclusive in what we're showing in the school, more people will join certain things in school because they don't feel like they're represented in the school environment, which makes it seem like, oh, certain people are getting involved and certain people aren't. It's a matter of getting more awareness so people feel more included in, you know, what we're showing people, and, you know, it makes a really safe environment for people. And then lastly, just honing off the school, you know, we've got respect. I just feel like respect is just like a given because, you know, it's how you treat people nice. Just having that more established within the school system will make like a really good change as we progress through sixth year, and hopefully will make like a permanent change for like the other years to come. Moving on, we've got qualities and attributes. I feel like being head girl comes with a lot of responsibility and, you know, is a pivotal role in leadership. And I think having that representative of like the pupils is such an important thing, and there's obviously qualities and attributes that one must have to be, you know, such a pivotal role in leadership. For instance, I would say that I'm a confident person. I don't have problems speaking publicly, and I don't have problems speaking, you know, to people that I haven't met. I'd also say I'm quite a principled person. I think I have good morals that would really like raise the school higher, and, you know, your morals are really a play on you, and how you move forward with things really reflects you as a person. I'd also say I'm quite a conscientious person. You know, knowing the environment around you is really important. Obviously, I've been here 6 years, been here since first year. So it's like knowing your surroundings and knowing the kind of people in them is really like an important thing to me as well. Because, you know, you're a representative of the people. You've been here for 6 years and, you know, you're the kind of person who has to, you know, say, oh, this is what we should do. This is what I think would elevate the school into a higher place. So I feel like that's really important. There's so many things that could uplift the school, just even talking about awareness and inclusion, not really the superficial things, you know, making promises that I'll do this and do that. I want like really long-term promises rather than promises that can be changed when I leave. You know, doing this, so then there's a long-lasting effect. It's more, you know, I want to have long-lasting effects rather than something that's not even permanent. So having that, you know, education of awareness, so then people become more socially aware, is really something that's important to me. I think that's really important. And having that established within the school system is also something that I deem really important. So, you know, just showing stuff in PHSC, showing stuff, you know, just showing stuff in PHSC is like really important to me. So I feel like if we do that more and we talk about topics more, you know, it'll have a really long lasting effect, especially when like you're in first year, you're more influential at that age. So having, you know, a role model that when you're in first year, you're at a more influential age. So you're 12, like you look up to these people and you think, oh, they're doing this, they're doing that. They're socially aware of this. They kind of follow in your footsteps. So having that kind of role is really like important to me. My day is different to your
day. How did I even begin to explain to you an officer? I taught Katie biology in S3 and I heard she got 5 hires.
I heard she's a young STEM leader and a Star Rights ambassador.
One time, Katie Doherty wore army pants and flip-flops, so I bought army pants and flip-flops.
Pupil Council, STEM Club, volunteering.
I've known Katie since first year and she's overcame many challenges, like having me as a teacher. Katie's hardworking, dedicated, and most of all, she's very conscientious.
And now head girl.
One time, she punched me in the face. It was awesome.
Hi, my name is Katie. Yes, like in Mean Girls. And here are all the ways you'll benefit if you vote for me as head girl. Something that I think sets me apart from all the other candidates is the fact that I already have a solid plan of achievable goals that will make this the best school year for you. And I've already spoken to a number of you about the positive changes you would like to see in our school. The pandemic has caused all of us to miss out on a bunch of opportunities that the other year groups have had. So I want to capitalise on the new lifting of the COVID restrictions by pitching trips and rewards and activities for you, the pupils who participate in the life of the school. You deserve recognition and you deserve rewarded after all these years of missing out. Another issue some of you have highlighted is extracurricular activities, which once again, thanks to COVID, has been limited these past few years. You've told me that you aren't sure what's on offer for who or when, or that there's a leadership role or club that the school isn't yet offering. As a result, some people aren't part of any committees. I hope to remedy this so that you will all get the opportunity to showcase your skills and talents in areas that you're passionate about, and it will help contribute to your CVs. Another concern a lot of you have had is that the school isn't doing enough to promote diversity. That when it comes to race, religion, sexuality or gender identity, you feel underrepresented and excluded, and that's not okay. So I want to organise Culture Days in our school. I want to educate those about Black History Month and celebrate International Women's Day, Disability Awareness Month and Pride Month. I want to create a school community that is welcoming and is a safe space for all those in it. Something I know that a lot of us are upset about is the end of split lunches. And with hundreds of new first years starting, lunch and break can be quite hectic. In other schools, 6 years might be able to go to their common room to get away from it all, but in St Andrews, we're not that fortunate. So instead, I propose working at classrooms we can go to during these times. That way, there will be less people in the crush hall, and you'll have somewhere to go if you want to chill or study or hang out with your friends. In addition to this, I also think we'd benefit from more tables and seating areas in the crush hall. As mentioned before, I have already been a part of various clubs, competitions, committees in our school, and in doing so, I've been able to grow and improve greatly on my confidence and public speaking skills. Whether it's presenting to a class or to competition judges or the Lord Provost, I have had great experience when it comes to showcasing our school's achievements. One of the biggest tasks as a head girl is to give talks to parents and pupils, and I think I've got what it takes to deliver clear and impactful speeches. I would work very closely with the S6 leadership team, and there would be regular meetings to identify and tackle issues that we have in the school. If elected, one of my first acts as head girl would be to publish a survey so that you can give feedback on the areas that you think the school are doing well and areas that they need improving, because I want to make this the best year possible for you. So why am I right for this role? Well, throughout my school career, I've been able to showcase and improve on a variety of skills and qualities. I am dependable. When I've been given a task, I always try my hardest to see it through and fulfill it to the best of my abilities. You can rely on me to get things done in our school in a responsible manner. I'm also a very good listener. I like to be able to help people in any way that I can, and I know that sometimes just lending an ear is all a person needs to help them get through the day. I aim to listen to my peers and share their opinions and concerns to make their learning experience as positive as it possibly can be. I'm resilient. If things don't go as planned, I can stay calm under pressure and persevere and do the next right thing. I pride myself on my ability to organise, something I've been able to improve on through the various clubs, activities and events I've had a hand in helping with throughout the school. The role of head girl is not one to be taken lightly. It requires a lot of commitment and perseverance, and I think I have what it takes. I promise to make these positive changes within our school so that you can have the best year ever.
Hello, my name is Aroma Nwafor and I would like to be your head girl. You may recognise me, or you may not, it's probably because of the hair, it changes a lot. But that doesn't really matter. Here are some reasons why you should choose me to be your head girl. First of all, I'm an excellent communicator, so I'm really good at persuading people. This means that the ideas that you guys come up with are more likely to come to pass when I'm head girl, rather than just stay on pen and paper. During my engagement with the majority of you, one of the many ideas that you came up with was to bring back the S6 common rooms, as well as adding some more accessible water fountains. These are part of the things that I hope to do when I become head girl.
I would
also like to include more cultural events that celebrate different cultural backgrounds as well as the LGBTQ community, so that everybody in the school can feel represented and involved.
So I think I'd make a good head girl because my charisma, my enthusiasm, just the way I am with people, it just makes it more likely that all your ideas will be put to use. Anything you want me to deliver, if it's appropriate, then it's more likely to happen. It's more likely to happen. Like I said, I have really good persuasive skills and I'm really good at convincing people to do things. So
my main goal as head girl is to represent the year group with honesty and enthusiasm whenever called upon. I would like this year to be an interesting year filled with lots of memorable and fun activities to look back upon when we leave. Collectively as a year group, I know we have lots of vibrant ideas that can positively influence the school, and I hope to be the person that you choose to be the embodiment of your ideas in hopes to bring about that positive change.
Victoria Crossley, and I'm running for head girl this year. I wanted to start off by telling you a bit about myself. I like geography and other STEM subjects, and during the summer I got the opportunity to go to the STEM camp where I was given a real life problem and we had to solve it within a group and then present our idea in front of others. I have contributed to our school within my role as a digital and social subjects ambassador. I have taken part in clubs and also helped in a classroom during lunch. I want to continue contributing to our school this year within my role as an ambassador as well as working with you. One thing that makes me suitable for this role is that I can confidently speak in front of a group of people, on my own and in a group. An example of this is when I talked at the 100 Days After COP26 event. Another is that I have already had experience in a leadership position in my ambassador roles. It has strengthened my teamwork skills and I can share my ideas well. I have great time management skills, which means that I can take part in events and help around the school. Another skill I have is good communication skills. As in the role of a head girl, I understand that people will come to me with ideas for changes around the school and talk to me about other important things too. I have shown this skill when I was helping in classes during Cyber Scotland Week. During COP26, me and a former sixth year got to attend the Achieving Climate Justice Forum in Glasgow Kelvin College. Amongst those who attended were professors and experts on how to fight climate change, with some of them leading branches in a climate reality project. During the event, we got to ask questions and later got the opportunity to speak to some of them ourselves. This year, I got the opportunity to talk at Glasgow City Chambers with Katie Docherty during the 100 Days After COP26 event. We made up our own script for the presentation and then got to present it in front of the school's attendant and the Lord Provost. This year I also got to talk in front of classes with other digital ambassadors about cybersecurity during Scotland's Cyber Week. And I will also be working towards my STEM leadership. I want our year to get more involved in activities around the school. One of these is creating more clubs during lunch, especially for younger years, which would mean they wouldn't have to spend all their lunches in the crush hall. For this, I would like if ambassadors from different subjects organise these clubs. This would also allow sixth years to get to know first years better. I also wanted sixth years to take part in primary transition programme throughout the year to work with primary sevens on their digital skills so that they're prepared when they join us in first year.
Hi, I'm Lillian Haas, and it would be a privilege to be your next head girl. Let me tell you a bit about myself. I enjoy playing netball, where I used to play competitively as centre position. I speak three languages and I have a talking pet parrot called Kobo.
Hello!
So, why do I want to be head girl? It's simple. I'm passionate about making a difference and believe that I can achieve this by helping the school community. It is a very important role which, if done effectively, can have a major positive impact on our school. Therefore, I believe that I'd be well suited for this. I'm one of those people who feels the need to be actively making a difference, no matter how small it is, in everything that I do. Hence the reason why I'm adamant in choosing a career that primarily helps people. Head Girl would therefore be the perfect platform for me to do this. In addition to this, my friends and family often describe me as being focused and driven, which is a crucial attribute in the person that you would want to represent you. I could give you a long list of promises like more school trips, but it's not only about my ideas, I want to hear them from you. So as Head Girl, it would be my main priority to listen to everybody's suggestions on how we can make our school a better place. After all, one of our school values is fairness. If you vote for me, I can assure you that your ideas will always be valued as we aspire to continue to establish an optimistic and happy school environment. One thing that I'm a huge advocate for is inclusion and diversity, especially being a girl of colour myself. I would therefore spend my time on educating and spreading awareness on things such as multiculturalism in the hope of encouraging equality and eliminating prejudice. I don't know about you, but when I was younger, I didn't really know who Head Girl was or who Head Boy was. So as Head Girl, I've made the leadership team more available and familiar to students to provide help and guidance to whoever needs it. I realise that being Head Girl is a challenging role. However, I believe that I'm the right person to represent our school as I embody the criteria of committed, innovative, determined and enthusiastic character.
Hello, I'm Rachel from 6-8 and first thing, I apologise, my video is not as fun as other videos, but okay. I hope S6 knows me, but anyone that doesn't know me, I am someone that is easily approached. You can good communication skills, I can talk to me anytime, and because of this, I have talked to a lot of people around the school from all the year groups, and I found out that a lot of people has good ideas that would make us, our school a better place, like really good ideas that I think should exist around the school, but it's not. Why? Because they're not telling the school, they're not telling teachers, because they think, oh, teachers doesn't listen to us, I don't like to talk to adults, etc. That's why I want to be the head girl. I would do the talking for you, I can do the communication part. Come and find me, email me anything, and then I'll do the speaking. I'll do the chase out, I'll annoy the teachers. And that's the purpose of leadership team, I think, because we are meant to be the bridge between pupils and the school, and we are meant to make things exist in the school that people would benefit from. So yeah, I can't make any promises, but I can try my best to, you know, help you to make the things, make the changes in our school. So please vote for me.
Hi everyone. So if you don't already know, my name is Kayla Ferguson and I am running for Head Girl. I'm sorry about the mess and the noise. I'm currently in the school's drama cupboard, so I'm really sorry if that's annoying. It's just as awkward and annoying for me as it is for you. I'm running for Head Girl because I really want to make a difference in the school, not just for our year group, but across all the year groups. And I think that Head Girl is something that can be really important and really special for a lot of people. Personally, to me, I think Head Girl is not just like a singular thing. I think Head Girl can only be Head Girl with the support of her peers, not just from the deputies and the head boy and the leadership team, but also from the year group and the year groups below them. I think this is a bit of a team effort. You know, we've been a bit of a team since S1. I'm sure a lot of us get on and some of us don't, but I think that everyone kind of needs to work together this year, especially now we've lost so many people to college, university and jobs and stuff. So I think that now's our chance to work together to make the school the place we want it. I'm sure some of you have things that you would love for me to say, I promise I'm going to get you this, I promise I'm going to get you that, such as I'm sure a lot of you would like longer lunches, some of you want split lunches brought back. I could promise you all of that, but I would be lying and I'm not going to lie to you. I've heard a lot of it through the years of empty promises and I don't find that fair on anyone. I would rather be totally honest with you about who I am and what I would like to do if I'm elected Head Girl. So for me personally, I would like to introduce things such as some more LGBTQ plus safe spaces, which would be working hand in hand with the wellbeing ambassadors for. I think there's work to be done on the school's mental health. I think there's work to be done, I know, through People Council that a lot of people wanted changes in the toilets. Some people wanted more things added to the school, such as clubs and different things. So there's a lot to be done there, which I think I would like to get a grip on if I am elected. I would also like everyone to contribute their ideas for how they'd want to change the school. I don't want this just to be a thing of I want this to be a thing of we want. I think it's really important that everyone gets involved in things like this, especially for whole school decisions. I think that's only fair. But more than anything, I just want to make this school an even better place for everyone. And that can come from your ideas, it can come from mine, it can come from younger year groups. I just think that it's really important that we all have a say in how our schools run and who runs it. Why I think I should be elected? Well, in S5, myself and Damalola, who I'm sure you will see or already have seen going for head boy, we were elected as your year group representatives, which I'm not sure all of you knew about, but that meant that we were put to a vote through People Council, and the two of us were elected to basically speak to teachers and things with the People Council's decisions on things that you presented us with, and that was us through S5, and as such I was a part of the People Council through S4 and S5. Also in S5 I was a part of the Star Rights Ambassadors group, which I'm sure you've heard of. So they did a lot of work for food banks, I was put in for mental health and helping P7s. We did a lot of work through that. We did things for International Women's Day. I know some people done things all about race and chose to teach you about the slave trade and the Black Lives Matter movement, which is all, of course, really important for everyone to know about and have a part in changing. Also, at the beginning of S5, myself and some of my peers, some of which you'll see go for head girl and head boy in a minute, such as Sydney, Katie and Mikhail, we all went up to Mr. O'Neill to basically advocate for LGBTQ+ young people within the school, because we thought that we need more LGBTQIA+ education within the school for everyone. So for those of you who identify as a part of that community, you'll know how important that was. And we had a big meeting with them to try and get that sorted. So already I've been making moves without being head girl to try and make this school a better place for everyone. I think we could be more accepting. I think we could be maybe just a little bit more diverse in the way we teach and the way we act. There's work to be done, and I think that as your head girl I can get a lot of that work done with your help, of course. But on that note, that is just some of the reasons that I would love to be your head girl, and so I would love it if you could vote for me. So thank you very much for listening and happy voting.
Disclosure: this video was 100% not made the night before it was due, and anyone who claims otherwise is making false allegations. Hello, my name is Deborah. You probably already know, but just in case, here is why I think you should vote for me.
During the last few days of this campaign, there have been posters, debates, and discussions of who will be the next head girl.
So let me tell you why you should vote for me.
If I were head girl, my agenda would be to support students who struggle with the school workload, provide facilities which allow students to regenerate, such as after school clubs, and promote staggered intervals. Because, let's be honest, no one actually likes the first years. There's a lot that can be done to make this a much more enjoyable year and make our school a better place for us and those that come after us.
Also, another reason why you guys should vote for me is because I am resilient to hate, and I think that's what everyone needs in a leader.
No.
Hi, my name's Kayla, and if you couldn't tell already, I'm running for head girl.
I'm going to give you a few reasons why me being head girl would be beneficial for the school. Firstly, I have a lot of energy, I'm bubbly and I can engage with a variety of different people and pupils of all age groups. I'm an approachable person and I'm someone you can come and talk to about anything. I also have the ability to transfer these skills into being an excellent head girl. Now onto the good stuff, I'm going to talk to you about the things that would be on my agenda if you chose me as your head girl. I feel strongly about the introductions of lockers for S6 students and this is my top priority. I feel like in our last year of school it should be as comfortable and as easy as possible and I feel like this would help support that. Due to the English department being moved up to the huts, it makes it that bit more difficult to arrive to class on time, especially if your period was in science or IT. So having these lockers would hopefully eliminate that problem. I'm also realistic, which is why I've had a discussion with Mr. McGee and he's open to the idea of having lockers, so this isn't any sort of false promise. Alongside this, I feel an S6 only area is vital in our last year of school, not only just for our study periods, but for any S6 people that need some alone time during what will be a very busy year. This may be a push, but I feel like it would be attainable. Again, this makes our last year at school as easy and as comfortable as possible. One of our main school values is kindness, and I feel us as S6 students should be promoting that throughout our school and leading by example to our younger and most impressionable students. I'm also introducing kindness cards with the help of an S3 pupil. This is for any pupil that has went above and beyond to be kind. And if you wanted to let that person be recognised, you can just fill out the card and put it in the kindness card box. It's also anonymous as well, so there isn't any embarrassment. This is mainly aimed at our younger pupils in order to promote kindness throughout our school community. Finally, yearbook and hoodies. I'm in close contact with the yearbook and hoodies lead for this year. I'm committed in working with them so that we have fun and good memories for our last year in school. I want to be the voice for our year group. This shouldn't just be a popularity contest. You need to put your trust in the new head girl that they will deliver, and I believe I can do so. I want to be head girl of this year group and leave lasting changes for year groups to come, for example, lockers and the S6 only area. Head girl is not only about representing the views of S6, but supporting the senior leadership team and driving positive outcomes for all pupils and staff.
Just studying.
Why do you think I should be head girl?
Because you're some laugh and you've got a good heart.
Hi, how's your day?
My day's been brilliant, Kayla. How are you?
Good. Why should I be head girl?
You're very confident, you're intelligent, and you're very talkative.
Thank you.
Hi,
guys.
I saw you.
Why
should
I think I should be head girl?
Because you're a really good friend, and I know you'll be great to everybody else, and you'll deliver all your promises.
You're definitely loyal and trustworthy in any promises you've made. You'll definitely follow them up.
I agree with both of them. Vote for Kayla!
You have experience in teamwork, so I think you could work well with the other deputy head girl and the head boys and deputy head boy, and you would also make sure to listen to the people in your year to make sure that what we want done is done and to the people of our school.
I just thought I would come and say that I think lockers would be really, really beneficial to our school, and Kayla has promised that as our head girl, she will introduce them or try.
Hi everyone, my name's Amy Hunter and this is my video about why I want to be head girl. So for the last week I've been trying to come up with a video that is enjoyable, isn't cringy and that you'd all actually enjoy. So I'm not very good at editing or anything like that, so we've settled on this, where I'm just going to tell you a few wee facts about myself and some ideas I have for the school. So I'll start off and just tell you a few wee facts. So on a Tuesday after school, I go up to Bishop Briggs and I help out coaching an additional rugby team, which is really great. We just go up, we do some different types of fun training, we're passing the ball around, stuff like that, keeping everyone entertained. And then we do a bit of touch rugby at the end, just so everyone's having a good time and getting to actually play the game. It's great to meet everyone there. They all have different personalities and all so lovely. My little brother goes and he absolutely loves it. He just loves to run around, throw a ball and that. It's great. Another thing about me is that I have a part-time job up at Shoe Kids, just up the fort. So if you're ever up there, feel free to pop in, say hello, embarrass me, whatever. I'm not too bothered. My job's really good, apart from when you get like the odd Karen who comes in and just tells you how to do your job, wants to complain about everything you're doing. And then you've just got like, yeah, okay, that's fine. Or when you have like a kid in who's just screaming at you when you're just trying to put a shoe on them. When these things happen, I normally just want to go hide in the stockroom and not come back out. But apart from that, it's good. So there's some wee facts about myself that some of you maybe didn't know. So some things that are important to me is to spread awareness about conditions like autism, epilepsy, or like ADHD and stuff like that, and then like mental health as well, so that people know how to treat other people, how to understand them better as well, because obviously not everyone's the same, we all have different personalities, all react to situations differently. I just think it's better that everyone is understanding others and just able to treat each other with kindness and respect that they deserve. Some ideas that I have for the school are, instead of everyone going out at lunchtime on just like a one big bundle, we do like a staggered lunch. So like 3 year groups go out like a few minutes early, just so there's not as long queues, because I know when you're up there, when everyone's out, you can be waiting in a queue for about 10 minutes. By the time you get back down to the school, but 10 minutes left to your lunch, you're having to rush it, you're not actually being able to relax. So think maybe a few go early, get up there, a few more extra minutes just to get stuff, and the rest of your groups up, come up, just so the shops are less busy and it's easier for the shops as well. Another idea I have is, obviously since free sanitary products is now a thing in Scotland, is making them more accessible in our school. So like if you've come to school, you've not realised you've started, and then you're not getting anything on you, so like in classrooms, maybe have like a wee box or like a wee cupboard with them in it, just so it's easily accessible, or making them more easy to get in the toilets as well, just so you're not having to feel a wee bit embarrassed having to go up to someone and ask. Another idea I have as well is for like in PHSE, obviously you get your PowerPoints about this, that and whatever, and sometimes it can be a bit boring and drag on, you're just there by the end of it just like, I want out here, this is just, oh no, I'm done. So I'm thinking instead of that, we do like interactive sessions. So like either like quizzes, talking to people who are experienced. So like for example, say you're in PHSE, you're watching a video about careers and you're like, not too sure what I want to do. I'm thinking maybe bringing different people from all sorts of careers. So like doctors, teachers, historians, engineers, builders, stuff like that, hairdressers, whatever. Bring them in, everyone go into like the gym hall, and then like all senior phase pupils be able to go up, speak to them all individually, have their own little stands, discuss what the job's about, what they had to do to get there, just so if you're not sure what you want to do, or if you just want to know a wee bit about more something that you're interested in, just so you're actually be able to learn from someone who's professional and knows what they're talking about. So yeah, I think that'd be really good. Or like if you're talking about, say, personal statements and stuff, and you're not sure about how many words it is, what to include, do like a quiz, so how many characters in your personal statement, whatever, when's deadlines, stuff like that, just to make it be more fun, a wee bit more fun and interactive. Another idea I've got is, obviously during lunchtime the Kershaw can be really crowded, so maybe allowing S6s to go into the meeting room, just so everyone has their own like bit of personal space and it's a bit more comfortable and everyone's not just pure squashed in and being able to move, not being able to move. And also a thing that's really important to me is getting your guys' feedback if you did vote for me, just so I know what yous are thinking, being able to implement your ideas, and so it's not just, I want this, I want that, blah, blah, blah. So I'm not just being like a dictator. I'd have everyone's ideas and try to find the best way to make everyone happy. So yeah, that's my video. Thanks for listening, and I hope yous might consider me for Head Girl. Thanks, bye.
Hi, everyone. This is Kyle McCormick. This is a voiceover, that's why my lips aren't moving. And welcome to Why I Should Be Head Boy. And how you won't get these 2 minutes back from your life. Sorry, couldn't help it. It was meant to be a minute 20. It is now 3 minutes 20, I believe. But at least you've got some, you know, PowerPoint transition effects to keep you through it. Number one, I'm resourceful. Well, you'll see examples of this in a minute, but examples of this. Well, I'm basically using this PowerPoint to read my lines because I couldn't remember them. I really couldn't. This was 6-7 takes just from that alone. I've probably bribed the teacher to use the big projector for style points. I did. This is Mr. Sanderson's room. Basically took a Snickers. More PowerPoint transition effects, you know, for high quality video, because I couldn't really speak in front of a screen, so this is my way to kind of help. You can even tell I'm stuttering during this voiceover. Two, I don't give up. You can see my face there. Some people make it annoying. I say some people, probably a lot, or relentless. They do. A lot of people do. I call it determination. It means I won't give up, no matter what. Even if it can be annoying or relentless. You know, just shows I'm determined. At 3, I have a dog. I do indeed have a dog. Her name is Maggie. This is my dog. You'll see her in a second. That is her. I have no idea why I added it. Probably just for style points. Enough said. More transition effects, you know, just to keep it a little bit interesting. I assume you've had some boring applications so far. Here are my goals. This is where it gets a bit more serious. My goal is to take my own, your suggestions and make them known to the school, maybe with suggestion boxes around the school or other means. Basically, I want you to be heard. I don't promise anything. I promise I will try my best. That's all I can really promise you. I don't believe head boy should be its own thing. I think they should be a voice for the people, because so many head boys just do their own thing when they should really be speaking for the students. Here's a meme that you could probably couldn't read. It basically just shows that your ideas will become my ideas when I'm giving them to the teachers, and that all your ideas will be known. I will give full credit to all the ideas that I give to head teachers and faculty. Thank you for listening. I really appreciate you spending time to take this. If I can't take head boy, at least I took 2 minutes, you can't get back. I hope you consider voting for me, and I really appreciate you guys taking your time just to sit and listen to my ramblings. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Maximum effort into everything I do, and I never give up. Another reason is because I care about our school and about our year group. Any concerns or ideas to make our year group better that you have, you can always bring to me, and I promise that I'll put maximum effort into making them a reality. The next reason is why I should be head boy, because I'm a good leader. I'm calm, collected, and organized. I'll get things done quickly and efficiently. The last reason that I should be head boy is because I'm a people person. I care about everyone in our year group, and I promise that I will not focus on one single aspect. I'll focus on everybody and everybody's wants and needs, and I promise that I will make our year group better.
This is the reason I think Dan will be a good head boy, because he has great leadership skills, he's very calm, and he's very smart, and he also brings joy to the people around him. So I think he should be head boy.
I think Dami Lola will make a good head boy because he cares for people, takes good responsibility and leadership, he takes people's feelings into consideration, and always knows how to lighten up a mess.
Hi, I'm Liam. I used to be Dami's team captain at Valleyside Basketball Club. Dami would make a great leader because he's caring, he's kind, he showed his communication on the court all the time. He always looked out for his teammates. When one was injured, he was ready to fill up that role and take leadership at any point.
Dermot should be head boy because he's a great leader and he is very good at listening to everyone's opinions.
I think Dami Lola should be head boy because he has great leadership skills, he works really well in a team and he always puts 100% effort in everything he does. He's also a really good listener and he makes sure to take everybody's opinions into account.
So something I plan to do this year to make me a head boy is to one, reintroduce vending machines to the workshop, have easy access to snacks and to lunch. Two, have a new culture day because last year culture day didn't really happen. Make me a head boy this year, everybody will be able to express their culture and where they come from. And the third thing that we do is have clubs and activities taken more seriously so we can have competitions so we can showcase the talents to the whole world to see.